everyone. Today we are going to discuss about two converters which comes in module 5. So module 5, it is related to the op-amp circuits. Various op-amp circuits we are going to study here. Okay, so the first one we are going to see, let us see the syllabus first. So these are the different topics included in module 5, that is op-amp circuits. The first chapter, op-amp circuits, and the second chapter related to the timer, 555 timer and its applications. So your digital to analog converter. So here, op-amp circuits, there are three converters we are going to see. One is digital to analog converter and the other is analog to digital converter. Under digital to analog, two converters we are going to see, that is weighted resistor and then R2R ladder network. Under analog to digital converter, successive approximation type we are going to see. Okay, and then small signal half wave rectifier, then active filters. Regarding the filters, we are going to study first and second order low pass and high pass Butterworth filters, band pass filters and band reject filters. Next is a 555 timer and its applications. So here mainly we are going to study about the functional block diagram of 555 timer, and then we are going to see the operation of monostable multivibrator and astable multivibrator and its applications. So today let us start with the first converter, that is digital to analog converter. So mainly why these converters are required, let us know about it. So data or signal processing using digital system is more efficient, reliable and economical. So whatever the data processing or signal processing using the digital system is there, which is more efficient than the analog system. So most of the physical quantities such as voltage, current, temperature, pressure, all these things which are analog in nature. So whatever the physical quantities are there which are in analog in nature, suppose if we want the data processing using the digital system, these analog systems should be converted into digital. So these are considerable practical difficulties in processing, storing, I mean the analog systems, which will be difficult, which are difficult in processing, storing and transmitting the analog signals without introducing the errors. Hence, for such purposes, it is often convenient to express these variables in digital format. Nowadays, data processing is mostly done using the computers, microcomputers. Such data processing involves transfer of data between the microcomputer and the input-output devices. Since digital systems such as microcomputers require data to be presented in binary form as a string of zeros and ones, we need to convert analog signals to digital form in order to process them using the digital system. So whichever the circuit that performs the conversion of analog to digital, then the such converters we call it as analog to digital converter or else A to D converter. Conversely, on the other hand, one more converter is there, that is the reverse one. Digital to analog converter, which is used to convert the binary output from digital system to an equivalent analog voltage or current. So here we are going to see these two converters, digital to analog converter and analog to digital converters. So let us see DAC, that is digital to analog converter or DTA converter. So this D2A converter, it accepts an n-bit binary word as input and generates a proportional analog signal at its output. So the output can be either a voltage or a current. So the widely used DA, the conversion, that is D2A conversion techniques employing the op-amps are binary weighted resistor DAC and R2R ladder DAC. So first we are going to see binary weighted DAC. So this is a figure which is given for 4-bit DAC, binary weighted DAC. Why I am saying it is 4-bit is, you can see in the figure, four different switches it has been used, single pole double throw switches it has been used from B0 to B3. Okay, that is why it is called 4-bit binary weighted DAC. And how the switches are connected, you see, one end of the switch, it is connected to the plus 5 volt. You can see here, one end, it is connected to the plus 5 volt, and the other end, it is connected to the ground. Means either the switches, it may take plus 5 volt as the input, or it may take 0 volt as the input. Okay, so switch can take two positions, either plus 5 or 0. So now, how these inputs are connected to your op-amp? So here this op-amp, it has inverting amplifier. When I say inverting amplifier, input is given to inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal is grounded. Since non-inverting terminal is grounded, that is V1 is equals to 0, even V2 should also be equals to 0 because of the virtual ground concept. Because I know the differential voltage should be equals to 0. So if V1 is 0, V2 should also be at ground potential. So whatever the current flowing here will be 0. So whatever the current will get here, that entire amount, it will go to your feedback resistor. Okay, and to the op-amp, you're providing plus or minus 15 volt. Okay, now there are four different switches are there, and through the resistor, through the different weighted resistor, it has been connected to your op-amp input terminal. Okay, so the first switch, that is V0, it is connected through the resistor R. B1 is connected through R by 2, B2 is connected through R by 4, and B3 is connected through R by 8. Okay, now if I take R value as 10k, R by 2 means 10 by 2, which is nothing but 5k, R by 4 means 10 by 4, which is nothing but 2.5k, R by 8 means it is 10 by 8, means 1.25 kilo-ohm. Okay, now for a time being, one more thing I wanted to tell, since as we know, this is 4-bit converter, four different switches are there. So total how many input combinations we are going to get? Four different switches are there. So it is 2 to the power 4, means 16 different combinations of input from B0 to B3. And analog output should have 16 possible corresponding values. 16 different inputs, for those inputs, I'll be getting 16 different analog output. Now for a time being, let us see the operation of this circuit, how it is going to operate. So for time being, let us consider switch B0 is closed. If it is open, means all are connected to ground, means 0. 0, 0, 0, 0 is input. 0, 0, 0 is the input, B0 will be 0 because current flowing will be 0, output will be 0 volt. Now let us consider B0 is closed and all the other switches are open. When B0 is closed, indicates that B0 is connected to plus 5. So what happens, there is a current flows through this resistor, whereas here there won't be any current flowing. Okay, so now whenever the plus 5 volt is connected to this resistor, we need to calculate what is the current flowing in the resistor. Same amount, it will flow through your feedback resistor. By that, we can calculate the output voltage, because output voltage is nothing but it is voltage across the feedback resistor. Okay, so here we have taken R as 10k and voltage applied is 5. So what is the current flowing? I is equals to V by R. That is 5 divided by 10k, which is nothing but 0.5 milliamperes. Same amount of current which will flow to your feedback resistor, because here current flowing is 0. So the entire amount of current flows to your feedback resistor, that is 0.5 milliamps. And I know the feedback resistor value, we have taken it as 1 kilo ohm. So it is 1 into 0.5, that is I into R, which is nothing but voltage across the feedback, that is nothing but your output voltage of the binary weighted DAC. Okay, so 0.5 milli into 1K means it is 0.5 volt with a negative sign. Why? Because it is an inverting amplifier. Okay, now let us consider next case. When B1 is closed, B0 is open. So what is that input? 0 0 0 0 0 1 0. Okay, means it is 2 in decimal. 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 means B0, B2, B3 will be connected to ground, whereas B1 is connected to plus 5. So what is the current flowing to this R by 2? We know the value of resistor now, 5k. 5 divided by 5k means it is 1 milliampere. previously it was for V0 0.5 milli and for R/2 it is 1 milli now. So this current will flow to your feedback resistor. Instead of 0.5, we should mention here as 1 milli. 1 milli into 1K, which is nothing but minus 1 volt. Now consider two switches are on, that is V1 and V0 are on. So the input given is 0011, means it is 3 in decimal. 0011. So V3 is MSB, V0 is LSB. So it is 00113. 3 means, see, what is the amount of current flowing here? We have already calculated it is 0.5 milli. And when V1 is closed, we know what is the amount of current here? 1 milli. So when it reaches this junction, whatever the amount of current leaving here, that is nothing but amount of current entering to this junction, that is 0.5 milli plus 1 milli, right? So it is 1.5 milli of current it will be flowing over here. So it is 1K into 1.5 milliampere, which is nothing but minus 1.5 volt. Okay. Similarly, when all the switches are closed, similarly, you can obtain output for the all the 16 different combinations. Whenever all the switches are closed, that is the maximum value you are going to get, maximum output value, all the switches are closed. So what is the amount of current here? 0.5. What is the amount of current here? 1 milli. What is the amount of current flowing here? It is 5 divided by 2.5K, which is nothing but 2 milliamperes. And then 5 divided by 1.25K, which is nothing but 4 milliamperes. So in this junction, what is the amount here? 0.5 plus 1, 1.5 plus 4, 5.5, sorry, plus 2, it is 3.5 plus 4, 7.5. So total amount of current flowing here is 7.5 when all the switches are closed. So it is 7.5 milli into 1K, which is nothing but minus 7.5 volts. So when all the switches are on, the maximum voltage, output voltage is minus 7.5 volt, 5 volt. So this is the operation of binary weighted DAC. So this, depending on whether the switches V0 to V3 are open or closed, but the binary weighted currents will be set up in the input resistors, that is in R, R/2, R/4 and R/8. The sum of these current is equal to the current flowing through the feedback resistor RF, which in turn converted to a proportional output voltage V0. When all the switches are closed, the output will be maximum. It will be calculated like using this formula. Output voltage V0 is equal to minus RF into V0 is the first bit, LSB bit, and the weighted resistor for that is R, V0 by R plus V1 by R/2 plus V2 by R/4, and MSB is V3, V3 divided by R/8. By using this formula, we can calculate the output voltage as well. Okay, now this graph, it shows how the output we are going to get for the 16 different combinations. See, as I have discussed, for one binary input, one value 0001, V0 as 1, 0.5, minus 0.5 as the output. See, you can see here all the values we have represented, it is minus below the ground level because we are using inverting amplifier. Suppose if you make use of non-inverting amplifier, then it will be above the ground level. We can use either inverting or non-inverting amplifier for the DAC. Okay. Similarly, you can observe here for all the 16 combinations, we will be getting in terms of step waveform. It is a step waveform. So when you calculate the step over here, that is from 1 to 2, what is the step voltage? It is 0.5. Similarly, from 2 to 3, 0.5. So step voltage remains the constant. So this step voltage depends upon the feedback resistor RF value. So here we have taken 1 kilo ohm. Suppose if I take 2 kilo ohm, then what is the change? Step voltage might be 1 volt. Okay, only that is the change. Okay, and the last output for the 15, for 15 we are going to get 7.5 volt as the output. So here disadvantage is that it requires weighted resistors which may not be readily available. This is only one drawback. So it is not most commonly used DAC converter. Okay, so this is the operation of your binary weighted digital to analog converter. Okay, and in the exam, you may expect this question for 6 marks. At that time, you need to explain this figure, then the explanation, and you have to give 2 or 3 examples, like when the switches are closed, what is the output you are going to get, and you have to explain this output voltage equation, and then you need to draw this graph and explain this graph. And then the one problem related to your digital to analog converter with binary weighted resistor, which has R of 10 kilo ohm. R of 10 kilo means binary weighted resistor value R as 10 kilo ohm. Determine the size of each step. As I told, size of the each step depends upon the feedback resistor. So let us know how to calculate the size of the each step. And the feedback resistor value is given 1.2K. What is the output voltage when the input binary word is 1111? Assume VR is equals to 5 volt. That is your reference voltage. The switches will be connected to this 5 volt. So size of the E step depends upon the RF value. So the formula is RF by R into VR, which is equals to 1.2 divided by 10 into 5. Okay, 1.2. So 1.2 is feedback resistor value divided by the binary resistor value 10 into VR is 5 volt. If you calculate, you will be getting 600 millivolt as the step volt. That is, from one input combination to next input combination, there will be a step voltage of 600 millivolt. Size of the step is 600 millivolt. Next, we know the equation how to calculate the output voltage. Use the formula, that is minus RF by R into V naught divided by R. So R we have taken outside. So this will be V naught into the weights. That is 2 power 0 means 1 plus all the bits are 1 here. So this will be common 1, 1, 1, 1. Only the thing is weights are going to different. 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3. That into 5 VR. You will be getting the output voltage as minus 9 volts. So you may expect the same question, similar kind of questions in the exam also. Okay. Thank you. I hope this session was useful for you. See you in the next session. So next session, we will be discussing regarding the R2R ladder network. Thank you.